Hi everyone, my name is Châu Bích Nhi and I'm competing for Public Speaking Champion by JCI Vietnam on the topic of community health. Speaking of community health, the first thing that comes to mind is women's health. This does not refer only to her physical condition but to her total well-being. And some may argue that women's health is the most important aspect of today's community health. And this is not just my biased opinion because I'm a woman. It is because community health is somewhat tied to women's health. Specifically, policies that enable women to lead lives with accessible and adequate health care will also improve the well-being of future generations. One famous slogan, "Healthy Women, Healthy World," really embodies the fact that women play a crucial role in maintaining the well-being of the overall community. Having that said, it really tugs me at a heartstring because still in most societies, women have lower social status than men, producing unequal power relations. Thus, we are vulnerable to human rights abuses and suffer poor health outcomes as a result. It is rather blatant that women have specific health needs, but health systems around the world are constantly failing them, according to WHO. Thus, it is our mission to improve the well-being of women on a global scale. Sounds pretty big. So what can we do? The first agenda is to improve maternal health. Did you know? More than 500,000 women die every single year during pregnancy due to entirely preventable causes, and 99% of whom live in Global South countries. In Sub-Saharan Africa, where roughly half of the world's maternal death occurs, only 46% of which are attended by a qualified health professional. Having that said, we need to support universal education and health strategies that aim to increase the proportions of deliveries attended by professionals. It is also important to make available and adequate reproductive health services and family planning. But global efforts to improve the health of women largely focuses on sexual and reproductive health. But what about our physical and mental health? It is nowhere near the current agenda. Thus, as a community, we must cooperate to reduce violence against women and enhance the support for victims of violence. Empowering women against domestic and family violence should be a priority in promoting overall good community health. During quarantine, the cases of domestic violence witnessed a surge, and that is undoubtedly a bad sign. And did you know? Studies found that at least 1 in 3 women will be the victim of abuse at some point in her life. Now, unfortunately, only a minority of women who experienced domestic violence go on to report the incidents, meaning that violence against women remains a hidden problem with many healthcare costs. The ablest strategy to reduce domestic violence is to include culturally sensitive methods to educate and empower high-risk groups to speak out. And this will not only improve the life of individuals, but also it will support the entire community health. In conclusion, as a community, we need to act on the goals outlined above and implement practical strategies to ensure these goals are met. The time has now come to take action to fulfill the fundamental needs of women's health. Not only does it help us achieve the current goal of overall stable community health, but it also guarantees a safe and healthy life for future generations.